for a brand new episode of Kill Tony. Give it up for Tony Hinchcliffe.
Yay, everybody, it's me. How you guys doing? Believe it or not, this is episode 30 of Kill Tony, everybody. 30 Mondays in a row. Wowzers. How exciting. I'm happy to be here. Yeah, I said wowzers, and I have no hesitation about it. I had hesitation before I said the word hesitation, though. That was weird. Live show, people. Anything can happen. It's a live episode of Kill Tony. We did not rehearse this. I just got back from Youngstown. It's Christmas week.
Yeah, you were in and out.
Oh, my God.
That's the way to do it. Freezing as fuck, I bet.
I didn't go back to my hometown for 5 years, and then I just went back this weekend, and it was fun. I did shows there, and it's interesting because, you know, we do the road a lot, and I'm normally at a hotel, which I love. You know, you walk into a hotel room, the door closes behind you. You throw off your clothes and you just start jerking off, and it's so much fun. I just love hotels. But my mom, she's like, I'm like, what hotel should I stay at? She's like, you're not staying at a hotel. You're staying with me. And I'm like, this should be interesting. I'm going to see how this goes. And the thing that's weird is, you know, it's Youngstown. If you guys don't know, it's like the murder capital of everything. Even Detroit's just more spread out. There's more people, so they get a bigger reputation. But Youngstown's like a dilapidated, dangerous city. And she's a little bit on a suburb of it, but still, you know, there's something to be concerned about. Your eyes are open. It makes you a certain type of person. Anyway, so she's showing me around her house that I'm supposed to be sleeping at. And the first thing I notice, I don't know if it's a Youngstown thing or my mom's getting much older thing, you know, she's 67, but there's all these dolls sitting around.
What kind of dolls?
Like creepy dolls, like antique-y, like dolls
like
that are
ceramic,
like smiling.
Or like soft.
There's some ceramic. Hard? Yeah, mostly ceramic, mostly hard. With like wobbly, like
with glass faces and shit.
Right. So I notice a couple in the living room. I eyeball the couch and the bigger, you know, the big TV, and I'm like, this looks like a sweet place to crash. This is probably where I'm crashing. But she's like, no, come upstairs, look at the guest bedroom where you're gonna be staying. And I walk in and there's like 50 of these dolls. And they're all pointed at the bed. And I'm like, I'm not staying in here. So that was the first night. So I crashed in the living room. I come home at like 3 in the morning. I heat up some killer. My mom makes the best spaghetti sauce, of course. Every Italian boy will tell you that. But my mom makes the best sauce. So I scarf down this huge plate. I'm in the living room. I throw down a couple blankets. I'm laying there. The lights are off. The TV's on. And there's the two dolls that are in the living room are right underneath the TV. So I'm seeing this glistening as I'm like falling asleep. I started getting really paranoid. I've always had a thing with them because when I was a kid, Child's Play came out. Remember that with Chucky? And I had one of those My Buddy dolls. Remember My Buddy?
Yeah.
Like for some reason, this movie and that doll came out at the same time. And I had both. I had seen Chucky and I had that doll. So from when I was a kid, like dolls at nighttime sort of creeped me out because at the end of the night, that My Buddy doll would be staring at me. So there I am looking at these two dolls, and I'm thinking to myself, I'm in the most dangerous fucking city, and here I am creeped out about these two dolls. And then I start thinking, like, wait, what if it's these two dolls that are killing people, and they're just getting away with it?
Yeah.
Because they're fucking dolls.
Maybe your mom is, like, held hostage by these fucking doll class
Could be,
faces.
And she wouldn't be able to tell me, or else they would find out and kill all of us.
Did you end up staying at a hotel?
I forget. No, I stayed both nights
you're
there.
You're crazy. I try to stay with my mom every time I'm back, but she does the annoying shit that brings back, like, the memories of being a kid. Like, we're at, like, 8 a.m., she's just like, Brian, do you have breakfast? And you're like, shut the fuck up.
Yeah.
And then, like, two hours later, it's getting kind of late. You should wake up.
Oh, yeah.
You know, like that annoying shit.
Oh, she knows I would immediately just leave.
Yeah.
She knows I would leave it like right then. Yeah. I would be grabbing my bag and then going to a hotel and sleeping. And then I'd come back at like 2 o'clock to eat more of her spaghetti sauce. I mean, it's crazy. That's all I ate for 3 days.
Wow.
Insane.
Healthy vegan diet.
Hell yeah.
Yep.
Yep. Tomato sauce. It's the Christmas episode, and with us, as always, in special uniform today, put your hands together for the Iron Patriot, everybody. Motherfucking fire hazard for Christmas, for the Christmas episode.
I will lead these new Avengers into battle against anyone who would threaten our way of life. I am the Iron Patriot.
Fuck yeah, you are.
It's good to be here on Christmas with you, Tony.
Oh, boy. Okay. Creepy right from the beginning, huh? Okay, let's get into it.
I might go caroling after this. I look so stylish tonight.
Curling?
Caroling.
Caroling,
you know,
okay.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire. Jack Frost nipping at your nose. Have you ever had Jack Frost nip at your nose, Tony?
Tony?
No, I haven't. Have you? You don't even have a nose on that thing, so probably not.
I like to put some pie out for Santa, so he gives me the right gift. I want to talk to you, Tony.
Who puts pie out for Santa? What are you talking about? You mean cookies and milk?
Yeah. But I got some things to say to you. I enjoyed hearing you on Joey Diaz, The Church Is What's Happening Now, last week.
Yeah,
it was
fun.
It was an exciting episode, and you have made a strong connection with Joey because you've had similar backgrounds. Both your moms had aliases. But I learned something about you, and you talked about this. You said that your father, your real father, lived right a couple blocks away.
Yep.
He had another family.
Yep.
And your mom was his girlfriend for 16 years.
Yep.
Now, that kind of made me sad, and I thought to myself, maybe I could be the father you never had, Tony.
Oh, you son of a bitch. Wow.
You know, I mean, maybe we go to a Dodger game next spring. We have a little bonding. We can make up for those lost years.
This is getting very transgender.
Yeah. But also, I want to talk to you, too. I'm very proud of you. You gave me two Christmas presents last week. You also made a trailer, and I was thinking evil thoughts about you because I thought you weren't going to do anything. I had to come in 2 months ago early, and I thought you just wasted it, but you put it together. If you guys want to check this out, go on YouTube and type in Kill Tony Trailer. And you're going to see this great thing he put together. It edits all the comedians giving really strong points about how to do comedy. And then it even finishes off with Pauly Shore. It's really nicely done, nice music, nice editing. I was impressed, Tony.
Okay. Thank you for that promo for the show that people are already listening to.
Yeah, well, they need to check that out.
Fuck yeah.
Kimberly and Sarah are featured in it, too.
I've never seen anybody promo a promo before. I just said, hey, people, go look at this advertisement that Tony made.
Now, let me talk about this song I'm going to do tonight.
Oh, boy.
Okay.
For those of you that don't know, and I don't know how you couldn't possibly know this, the Iron Patriot was in a failed rock and roll band in Dallas in the 90s. And he was in two other bands as well. None of these bands ended up doing much of anything. But somehow he saved the music, and sometimes he sings for us these songs that are way too long. Yeah.
Sticks and stones can't break my bones, and words can't hurt me either, Tony.
Oh, it sounds like something's starting to bother you, though.
Okay. Taking you back to 1986, this was the first band I was in. It was called Romeo and the Dreamers. This was the first hit song I wrote. It's called One and One.
When you say hit song, like, what was it? What made it a hit, exactly?
Well, when you got people coming to the show, and they're all singing the song with you, that's a hit.
Were they really singing the song with you?
Yeah, we had a breakdown. You're not going to hear it because we're not going to play the whole thing, but there's a breakdown. Everybody starts singing One and One together. It's a very catchy tune, very festive. And if you guys want to sing it with me, you can. But, you know, it's not.
Well, how would anybody know how to sing it with you? That's my question. How?
It doesn't take long. It's One and One has always got to be two. But...
Oh, my God. Why do we do this
and
again?
You guys are going to Deep Ellum January 11th. Next month, you're going to the area where I did this song. So it's kind of all tying together here.
This makes no sense.
Yes, it does.
Clap your hands if you know what we're talking about right now. Slow clap from the top somehow.
They'll catch on.
Okay. All right, let's just go right into this.
Here it is. Okay. All of his songs are really weird and cheesy. It's like...
Yeah.
All right.
Turn up a little.
Running around just trying to have some fun. Worry over little things, never brought me anything. I just want to dance and sing my song. People living in despair, loneliness everywhere. No one cares enough about the earth. Let's have some fun. One in one, it's always gotta be two. One in one, it's always gotta be two. One in one, it's always gotta be never changing, always the same. One in one, it's always gotta be two.
Wow.
That just gives you a little taste right there.
One in one has always gotta be two.
It could be like two ears, it could be two eyes, it could be two lovers enjoying a walk together. One and one has always got to be two. It can be anything you want. Two balls on the banana, whatever.
Oh, wow. Okay. Well, what can I say? You know, that was actually probably my most favorite song out of all the ones you played. I'm a little bit surprised.
Aren't you impressed with my variety, Tony?
No, all the songs sound exactly the same.
No.
The only
no,
thing that
don't.
Changes is the lyrics.
No, they don't. No, they don't. Next week, I'd like to do a song for my second band called Shame. And then after that, we'll get back to some more Dirty Crabber songs. And then I have some solo songs when I was a solo artist.
Oh, wait. Can we just skip right to the solo ones?
Yeah, let's definitely cut out that...
cut out the middleman.
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, do you have a romantic solo song about a lost lover or shih tzu?
I'm going to take you on a journey, Red Band. You'll see.
Wow.
Can you play some of that without him... can you play some of it without him singing? I always love just hearing the actual part that he sings over with his robot voice compared to his actual voice. It sounds exactly the same.
It's like rusted root.
Without the, and he's the Iron Patriot. Iron doesn't get rusted. All right. So this is, how long is this guitar solo from GarageBand?
One and one has always got to be two. One and one has always got to be another chance. You know it's the same. One
is that
one
you singing?
I got expressions to make, Tony.
Whoa!
Iron Man, Steelia!
What?
Let me tell you, that is not me singing. That's my old friend Brian Hurley singing. But I wrote that song, and I played guitar in that band, and I just wanted to do it.
Do you think
I didn't have any way to take the vocals off there, but that's my best friend. He played in Dirty Crabber with me, too.
How do you think it would make Brian Hurley feel if he was just looking for a new podcast, and he saw you draped in Christmas lights and an elf hat singing his lyrics?
He'd love it, because he likes see me promote this song and get it out there so people can hear it. He'd love it.
Okay.
I mean, if you guys got a movie, somebody's a movie maker out there, put that song and get in contact when we get that song in the soundtrack.
Yeah.
It can mean a lot of things, you know?
Yeah, like, what's that, Cowboys movie? Like a sequel to that Cowboy movie. What's the gay sex Cowboy movie?
Oh, Brokeback.
I've ruined that one.
Maybe some kind of like kids show.
Yeah. Anything.
One plus one is always got to be two.
Yeah.
Like maybe you could have different math songs, like three minus three is zero.
Good idea, Tony.
Oh my God.
I don't like that anymore.
I know.
Now it's forced.
Yeah, you're really beating it. You gotta just relax.
Nope. I'm an enigma. I'm very mysterious. I work in strange ways.
I love it. Put your hands together for the Iron Patriot, everybody. So loyal, so cool. I'm really excited about this episode. As always, I have two of my funniest friends and comedians and a bunch of... they have many credits. They're so much fun. I'm so excited to have both of them here tonight. They've both done the show once before, so this is both of their first return. And here they are. This young man just wrote an NBC untitled pilot. He made it, got it filmed. The untitled Gerard Carmichael NBC pilot. One of my best friends. We started together. It's Willie Hunter, the host of The Will Hunter Show, once a month in the main room. And the co-host on his show opens for Rob Schneider, tours the country, one of the back-of-the-room assassins, considered one of the top comics here in Hollywood. It's Big Earl Skakel, everybody. There he is. Powerful presence. A special Christmas episode. Fuck yeah. Willie, how are you? Earl, welcome. Guys, it's so good to have you back.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
Heck yeah.
Yeah, Merry Christmas. I like that guy's song, by the way. I'd like to get a single of that if I could.
Really?
That's totally out of the 80s.
Yeah, I like to send me your email on Twitter. I'll send you the MP3.
I'd love to get it, man.
Willie, I want to talk to you.
I bet.
Okay.
Right now?
I did some reading. Did some research on you today. Came out to California at the age of 21. Left Georgia. You came on the bus.
Alabama.
You came on the bus. You only had $400 in your pocket.
0 for 1.
now, on Kill Tony 12, when I was coming down here, I was riding the bus with you. Now, have you ever had a car, or what's your situation?
Oh, my God. You know, you can ask that after the show, but...
Real smooth there.
Yeah. Yeah.
Real smooth.
Never had a car out here.
Well, it's a good
2008.
City for getting around without a car. It doesn't really matter, does it?
No.
Great question, Patriot. I mean, you know, the way you threw that together, really interesting.
Yeah, let me talk to you, Earl.
Yeah, no problem.
You drive a 2013 Camaro.
I noticed that you're a fan of the band Rat like me.
Yes, yes,
and
indeed.
First time I met you, you were wearing a Rat t-shirt.
Yes.
Now, I got a story to share with you.
I bet.
Now, the first time I smoked a joint was listening to Round and Round. Because back in 1985, I worked in the paint department at Sears. Had a hippie friend. After work was done, he took me out in his Trans Am. He handed me a joint for the first time I smoked this thing. It was like smoking a beer. He put on Round and Round. And that song jams. It was a magical moment. I wanted to bond with you man to man over there, because I know you like Rat.
Yeah, we're bonding.
Oh, yeah. Thank you. Earl's never smoked pop before.
Never, man.
Yeah, that was sad when Robin Crosby died. I hate to see that happen.
Of AIDS.
Yes, but he it was actually a heroin overdose. He got AIDS the year before, but that's a good memory there.
You know, you kind of look like RoboCop with AIDS.
Huh? Wow, robot insult humor. I like that. You don't get to see that very often. You know what, robot? You remind me of
Earl. You've never really ever even taken a hit of a joint.
I've never had a drug or drink in my life, which is why I look so good.
Would you ever try? Do you think you'll ever try? Are you just scared to? Or
no, I don't want to end up
having like smiling.
Yeah. I like my disposition. So.
Also, Willie, I want to say one more thing before we go.
I'm sorry.
I heard you talking on a podcast that you went to one of those cocaine Hollywood parties.
Yeah.
And you didn't like it. Now, but you didn't do cocaine. Do you think you would have liked it more if you did cocaine at the party?
No, there was enough.
No, I'm talking to Willie.
Oh, well. Well, sorry, you're looking right at me.
Do you have an answer, though?
Well, no, I think yours will be better.
Both talk about going to a Hollywood Coke party while on a podcast?
I don't think so.
Interesting. Let's hear both of their answers.
Yeah, well, he was talking to you, so.
I don't know how to answer that question.
What was the root of the question, Patriot?
Well, remember, I heard you on that podcast, Willie, talking about how you went to a cocaine party, one of those Hollywood parties.
Yeah.
But you didn't do cocaine because you never done it, and you didn't like it.
Yeah.
You didn't like the experience. Yeah. Do you think you would have liked it better if you would have done cocaine with him?
Yeah, I guess.
Yeah.
You are very good at asking questions.
Are you being sarcastic, Willie?
Oh, I like that. Oh, man. That's like Tom and Jerry.
That's his thing. He says the person's first name at the end of the sentence sometimes.
That's his
for a very
right
creepy
there.
Effect, yeah.
It's like an 80s black woman.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. He started hosting the open mic in 2010, and I'm kind of sad I didn't get to go to that process. I just kind of came on this show, but it must be an interesting process going through that open mic thing. I hear a lot of people have to struggle through that.
Did you say you did do an open mic?
No, I was saying I didn't go through that process like other people, but that must be a good learning experience. I heard you talking a lot about that when, you know, going through the open mic, and when you get here, nobody explains what's going on.
Are you still talking to me?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah, sure.
Yeah, you know what I'm talking about, Willie.
This guy's a regular Carson Daly with these questions.
I love it. Well, hopefully it won't be too big of a fire hazard what we have going on with them tonight. I sort of just draped those things over there. So, here we go.
Put some presents underneath me?
Anyway, fuck yeah, everybody. So that's the Iron Patriot. Here are my guests. Are you guys ready to get this thing started or what? You know how it works. We had many comedians sign up tonight, 25, I do believe, in total. And they get to come up here and do 1 minute of material. And then we try to help them out, talk to them with what they just went through, and maybe give them some punch up or just see how it goes. So we talk to them because they're comedians. They get 1 minute at the end of their 60 seconds. You know your time's up when you hear the sweet sound of a kitty. Adorable. That's when you know to wrap up your time, because your time's up. If you keep going too long after that, you're going to bring out the West Hollywood Angry Bear. And he sounds extra angry tonight.
You say that every single week.
I know. And I'm really excited about this episode because I know, Willie, you're like a regular host here. And Earl, you are considered one of the hardest working guys on the circuit. I mean, you many spots a night always. So you guys are in the depths of the comedy world. So I'm excited to hear what kind of feedback and questions you ask and what happens here tonight. Are you guys ready to get this started? It's Kill Tony 30. And your first comedian tonight is Sarah Kenny.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way.
So I find it hard to find a place to live. I got some roommates to try to save money, and then right away they started doing annoying shit, like eating all my food, knocking me up. And then I did get knocked up, and the timing was really awful because my abortion Groupon had just run out. But, you know, the more I thought about it, I was like, lots of people want babies. I could just sell it and really turn this thing around for myself. But you can't legally sell a human being, so I had to find a loophole. I put an ad on Craigslist that said, baby stroller, $10,000, everything included. And it worked out okay, but I did have to give the buyer kind of a discount just because that baby was so fucked up. I don't know how long that was.
That's 55 seconds. All right. Fuck yeah. I like that. So I just missed the beginning. So the baby was yours originally in this thing?
Or? Yeah, I got knocked up by my roommate.
Right. Okay.
And you were thinking of a way to get rid of it.
Yes.
There we go.
Right. Yes.
My abortion Groupon ran out, so I decided to sell it. And
you like saying that, don't you?
Yeah, I guess so.
I got a chuckle from someone. Someone laughed at abortion Groupon.
You can't go wrong with an abortion joke.
It's true. Especially when
But this is not about abortion, though, because the baby's alive now. This is murder now.
No, I'm just selling it. Selling it to, you know, some random person.
See, this joke's confusing to me.
Make some money. Yeah, it is confusing because I don't know whether it's real, and I don't know exactly what you're trying to do. Like at the end, it just goes, "The baby's fucked up." And it doesn't really end a story at all. Like was there more to that?
No, that's just
have up until this point.
Yeah.
Okay. So, is any of this true? Did you get knocked up by a roommate?
How many abortions have you had?
Half of it's true.
So you didn't get pregnant, but you had the abortion?
I did get pregnant. I did not sell the baby on Craigslist.
Backpage?
There you go.
Oh, I think I'm starting to figure it out. So you did...
Yes, that's what she had, an abortion, and she...
Yeah, that's our first Kill Tony live abortion.
No, I didn't
everybody.
Have
that's
an abortion. Okay.
And she kept her cell phone on and recorded it.
It took care of itself. Can we just say that?
Oh, wow.
Oh, God, yeah. Made an abortion.
Hello.
It was a miscarriage. Yeah.
Sure.
Wow.
What do you mean, this sure? Is, I mean, what do you mean it happened on
way
itself?
More than I bargained for.
Yeah, I know. It happens quick.
We got a whole new joke here now.
Yeah.
Did you put it in
Fuck
like a
roommate.
Ziploc?
We got to talk about this baby that just vanished out of thin air.
Who is the father? A potlucker?
All right. Okay. So,
yeah, I'm going to write all this down. This is really helpful.
Abortion jokes are really fucked up, though, to even try to do. Seriously, because, I mean, you're pretty much telling half the audience you're going to hate you immediately. Like, there's people like myself that are like, yeah, but then the other half are like, fuck this girl. What the fuck? Is she being serious? Like, you really, like, even with baby jokes, I've found from just past experience, anything that has to do, you have to remember that you're pretty much taking your audience and splitting it down the middle at that point.
And I actually used to tell that joke without the abortion Groupon part, and it seems to work either way, but yeah. It's true. I definitely alienated people with that.
Yeah, well.
I think the $10,000 all things included with the stroller thing is funny, but I don't think that has to be about necessarily you or that same thing. I think that's funny, and that could be its own different thing about, I don't know. I don't know. That sort of got sad in the middle of everything.
Yeah, it was very sad. I was thinking about this baby. Did it have a name?
I was thinking about how many roommates you had.
That's a great question, too.
Fuck
and
yeah.
An orgy abortion joke.
All right.
Okay.
Okay. Right.
Well, so... yeah.
So if anybody needs a roommate, just let me know. I'm in the,
there you go.
I'll give you an abortion.
Oh, my God.
This is a weird episode so far.
You ain't lying, bro.
I smoked way lying. Too much weed. It was indica instead of sativa.
Oh, my God. What a debacle. I mean, it's really not even, it's not even the weed. It's just the universe at this point.
Right.
I mean, Sarah could have gotten picked out of that bucket at any point. You know what I mean? But we just started it off and...
And that's why openers are important.
Yes, it is. Sarah, so fuck yeah. I'm still sort of just. What approach would you like to talk about on stage? Would you like? Would you ever talk about having? I'm still not positive whether you even want to cover this subject whatsoever.
I don't think so.
So probably not.
Well, I thought it's clear that it's not serious, but
is it not serious or is it serious?
Well, I mean, I think it's clear that the Craigslist part is not a real thing that a person would do.
Right.
Well, I'm not so sure about that.
Or maybe I'm just giving people bad ideas. So I kind of like that, you know, it sort of makes me have this very careless attitude towards something that is pretty serious.
Interesting. Okay.
Do you think it would be better if she made the baby black?
No.
Yeah.
Why does a black baby have to die in a joke?
Because it's just the way it is.
Yeah. No, no. Some white babies need to die some jokes too. Always a black baby.
I mean, it's just the way it is.
That's what I meant by the baby was so fucked up.
That it was black?
No, I'm just kidding.
Oh,
see, there we go.
Yeah.
Sweetening it up.
No, I was trying to imply that I had been like debaucherous during the pregnancy, but maybe that wasn't clear. Like that I was drinking or that it was messed up in some way that. I was trying to imply that it was my fault that it was messed up.
Right.
And so that might not be.
Oh, fun. See, I got lost with all that.
It's not the guy's fault.
Yeah, and why you bring this roommate in there? He gave you the greatest joy of all, a baby. And then you just threw it all away.
He gave you a
and
big
now you're just
one.
Gonna tell a joke about it like it's nothing.
He gave you a big one and now you're blowing it.
Well, I guess I'm a thankless roommate.
Maybe there's something funny in, like, maybe the, you know, maybe you could just say, you know, I got really drunk at a party and hooked up with some guy, and I swallowed a Plan B pill after he came inside of me. You know, maybe something, anything, well, but I really don't know. It all depends on how real and true it is, and it depends on what you really want to talk about. I'm really confused right now.
All that shit's really overplayed, though. It's very hacky. The Plan B jokes, a million comments.
Well, it sounds like it's true. If I'm, is that what happened? You got knocked up, and then what?
She had a miscarriage in real life.
Oh God. Okay.
Did that really happen?
It happens all the time. It's more common than you would think.
With you?
You got that right.
Yeah.
It can happen very early on.
Yes, it can.
Any miscarriages out there? Yeah. Two dudes, that's it?
That's it.
I'm sorry for you
They
guys.
Were the miscarriages. They made it.
I've never heard a female comedian do a miscarriage joke, and I encourage you to write it, because that sounds like what happened. So if you can talk about that and you have a couple minutes about it, then it could be a killer bit. No fucking around. But it hasn't started here, and I don't know where it begins. So, good luck with that. And I don't know what else to say. That's creepy.
Buy a puppy.
Thank you.
There you go. Sarah Kenny, everybody. Skenny comedy. Very interesting way to... very interesting.
Wow.
Oh, my God.
I hope this next is, like, very lighthearted.
Please get a white power
maybe
joke.
Maybe a guitar.
It's weird when, like... Because, like, what happened there was... I mean, I got confused, and I'm trying to think in my head, like... Did she have an abortion? Did she have a miscarriage? Did she take the Plan B pill? And it's like all these three options are all just babies dying. It's like I have babies dying in my head.
Yeah, there's a...
See how quiet it gets and how weird...
It's made this whole place very awkward.
Sarah Kenny's excited.
I hope I have the... I better have a happy song.
Okay.
You better play 1+1 again.
Oh, boy. Put your hands together for Timothy Cash, everybody. Timothy Cash.
Buddy, one thing that I really do need... Santa baby...
Any racists in the crowd tonight? White supremacists out there? No? Good. Personally, when it comes to white supremacy, I think the only people that can really get away with it are the albinos. You know, if I hear an albino talking about white supremacy, I'm not going to argue with him. Figure he's earned it. If not supremely, he's extremely. What I really like to see, though, is a white supremacist rally interrupted by a bunch of albinos. You know, you got your Grand Dragon up here preaching white is right, then enter the albinos, barreling through the doors. What the fuck is going on here? A white supremacist rally. We weren't invited. Really? Man, that's a nice tan you got there, buddy. You see that? It's not sunburn. Somebody took my picture with a flash. White supremacist my ass. We're supreme. Like sour cream on a taco.
Oh, wow. We just started with the bear, huh? All right. Fuck yeah.
Perfect post-abortion material.
Hell yeah. Timothy Cash. Fuck yeah. Where are you from?
Kansas.
Nice. How long have you been in L.A.?
I got here Thanksgiving.
That's awesome, man. Heck yeah. That's great. Okay, so we're talking about albinos. That's fun. That's a fun twist on that I've never heard, albinos and white supremacists, you know. Fuck yeah. Do you really hate black people?
No. Be honest. Don't hide it.
Has anybody ever told you that you remind them of Trevor from GTA 5? No. Okay, well.
I don't hang out with a bunch of gamers.
Sorry. Yeah. So what have you been doing? What's a Kansas guy been doing in L.A. since Thanksgiving? What are the sights you've been seeing? What do you notice about L.A.?
I pretty much just hang out at the beach.
Yeah. That's fun, right?
That's
all right.
I live in a camper.
Nice.
That's where you wrote that joke?
Does it really, like, actually come across as racist?
No, not at all.
You're just talking about white supremacy. I mean,
Come on. Well, the whole thing is, I start with white supremacy, and I completely go in a different direction. It really has nothing to do with white supremacy.
No, right. I know. It doesn't come across as racist. I was just talking about your overall look and the fact that you're from Kansas. It had nothing to do with even the material when I asked you if you were a racist.
Listen, if you are, this is the right club to be at.
Yeah.
Did you do stand-up when you were there?
Yeah, see, I mean, I was in Kansas. Kansas has, like, one place at Stanford's. But it's not the original Stanford's. It's, like, a new one that's, like, a 30-minute drive out in the middle of nowhere. And I was going out there once a week. I mean, I was doing all right there, but, I mean, there was 10 people in the crowd, and there were the other comedians waiting to go up.
Right.
So I had the camper. I was like, fuck it. I'll go out here.
Hell yeah.
Of course, out there, you call up, and you just say, all right, I'm going to be there. And you go do stand-up. So you get to do it every week. I didn't realize out here it was such a...
Yeah.
Big deal just to get 3 minutes.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Shit happens.
Fuck yeah. What do you do for work?
I'm with Central Casting, so nothing.
Oh, interesting. You know, one of the top background artists in the world is right there next to you.
I work with Central, too.
I bet. Nice.
Oh, he's giving the fist pound.
Another background artist.
I just recently called the other day, and they're off for 2 fucking weeks. Oh, sorry.
Yeah, it's a slow time right now this time of year.
Yeah.
But I recommend to you need to get a calling service. It's not good enough just to be hooked with Central.
Does that really work?
You got it right across the street, Extras Management. I'm with Jessica's A-list. You get with Joey's list.
I'll do it.
Give her one of those. They get the jobs for you. You pay them like $60, $70 a month. Yep. They get the jobs.
Thank you.
That's right.
Perfectly timed.
I don't think the listeners are too interested in becoming background artists. So,
artists, too.
It's funny that they call them artists. Yeah. That's really the one. Like, I even think that sandwich artist is a little bit more artsy than background artist.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, in background artists, they literally tell you, stand there and don't do a fucking thing. Yeah. If you do anything, you're fired, and we're bringing in this other guy over here.
I recommend it to anybody that comes to L.A. because it'll show you. You'll drive all around the suburbs of L.A. and you'll learn a lot about where everything is.
It's I'm learning where everything is.
Yeah.
That's all I do is drive around and walk around.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That's great. What beach are you living at?
it's like right at, I think it's Vista Del Rey.
Marina Del Rey.
Marina Del Rey.
Yeah.
That's a nice area.
Yeah, that's cool.
I don't get fucked with. I can park there whenever, as long as I want.
Mm-hmm. Cool. That's fun.
It is, actually.
No, I know.
I'm reading like a book a day.
Wow.
Oh.
Yeah, for a guy that looks like you, that's like insane. A book a day. I never would have guessed that.
Is it an audio book or is it a...
electricity.
Okay. So.
I've always wanted to. I've always imagined doing that, just buying a trailer and living in your trailer. It seems so nice.
No, it's not.
It's not.
It's right. Not at all.
It's a cool thing to do for a little while.
Have you brought a girl back to your trailer?
Fuck no. Oh. The only people that sleep with homeless people are homeless people.
What about a dude? You ever bring a dude?
It's not really homeless.
That's
though.
Not really.
It's
homeless.
Not really homeless.
No.
Yeah, you got a camper.
It's home some. I mean, it's a
home yeah, some.
It's a tiny camper. Like it's like a walk-in closet with a bed is what it is.
Where do you take a dump?
It's cool because it actually, believe it or not, it's small, but it actually has a shower and a shitter.
Oh.
Otherwise, I wouldn't even consider coming out here. I'm not gonna be like one of those bathroom shower guys.
Why not?
Just because I couldn't do that. I mean, I expect it's gonna take me 6 months to a year to even like hopefully get like 5 minutes a week. You know?
Might
so
take
like,
a bit longer.
So, I mean, I could live in a camper without the shower.
Oh. So,
fuck
good
yeah. For you, man.
Yeah, totally. That's
guy,
great.
Right?
Balls, absolutely. Man. Timothy Cash.
Yeah.
Takes a lot of balls.
That was a very fun minute. Fuck yeah. There
suggest,
he goes.
Can I say one thing for
yeah,
him?
Yeah.
I would rather him talk about that.
Yeah, totally.
Like, that's some interesting shit than white supremacists and albinos. I mean, no offense,
right.
Nate Hurd, but I don't want right. to hear anything about Nate
it's
Hurd.
It's true.
I'd yeah. stick with the white supremacist stuff, yeah. but that's
but that is interesting that he's, you know, making those sacrifices. But that's actually, you'd be surprised, I think, Timothy, because most people, when they get here, it's sort of like the same thing, or worse. Some people are sleeping in just back seats of cars and couches yeah. of people that they don't want to be living with. So at least you have your own trailer where you can just fucking crash. It's really not that bad. I've heard horror stories. But having a trailer by the beach actually sounds like something I think almost anybody could get into for a week yeah. or so.
I would like it, I think. One of those big silver ones, like the yeah. really, really nice
My
ones.
Brother once did that. My brother once lived out here in an RV for a long time, actually, for like 2 or 3 years. But it was huge. It's like a tour bus. Oh. So it was actually awesome. It had 4 beds in it.
Wow. That's awesome.
Yeah.
Right.
But there you go. What I love about Timothy Cash, I mean, I'm sure you know that he wouldn't have a Twitter. But
smoke cloud
on the, what he wrote in where normally comedians sign up and give their Twitter handle is just nope. He didn't leave it blank or anything. He was basically making a statement like, I'm not that guy. Anyway, so that's fun. Timothy Cash. That's a great name. Any relation to Johnny?
Nope.
Nope. That could be your get her done. Just nope. Anyway. You don't need to get her done.
You know, I keep hearing that theme come up when they get done that they say, you should have just talked about your real life. And I think that's something everybody should take to heart is talk about your real life.
Yeah.
Fuck yeah.
That just come to you?
No. It only
it's like you do that a revelation over there.
Well, I keep hearing it over and over. You know how Earl yeah. said that to him right now. That stuff was more interesting about being on the beach homeless.
No, yeah. I told him to stick with the white supremacist
or
stuff.
Willie said that.
It only
I also told him to stick with the white supremacist stuff.
Go with what you love. I mean, go with what.
Fuck yeah. I say do both. Do it all. Because that can get you into that. Anyway. This is a new name. Put your hands together for Chelsea Grow.
So my roommate came in the apartment the other day, and she was making a lot of noise, woke me up. And I was like, girl, what's going on? She was like, oh, I'm really sorry. I'm on like 3 different drugs. I'm tweaking right now. So I'm sorry if I woke you up. I was like, okay, girl, that's fine. I don't really care about all that. Just please don't eat my face. You know? Just so don't eat my face. Because, like, I don't know, like, y'all know about the guy who did the bath salts dying on that homeless man's face, which I find really shocking. Those had to be some low-quality bath salts to make a homeless man's face look appetizing. I don't know. But then, I don't even understand what possesses somebody to do bath salts. That doesn't even sound like a fun drug to do. You know, the reason you convince people to do drugs is because they have cool names associated with them. Like ecstasy, right? I want to go there. You know, that sounds like a land full of ponies and high credit scores. The McRib is always back. Like, I wanna go to ecstasy. And even, like, crystal meth. You know, crystal meth sounds like the name of a Mississippi girl lost in Walmart. Right. All right, I think that's about my time, I think. So.
Nailed it. That was exactly a minute. I'd get to that back end of stuff quicker, immediately. Like, I feel like there's a lot of setup on bath salts. Like, you know, I don't think anybody's going to eat your face because you go from one thing to the other. But I think the jokes are really on the back end. I don't think you need to make it real to get into it, you know? You could get into it almost anyway, if that makes sense. But the names thing is funny, like that crystal meth and all that. So what was I thinking? Oh, what was the other thing? Fucking bath salts. Yeah, I just feel like it's a little bit...
It's old at this
old
point.
Old to make the eating the face reference, because that had to be at least a year ago about.
Yeah, it was a year and a half ago.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I'd lose the eating the face and get right into that other stuff. But yeah, what are other drugs? There's other ones.
Molly.
Yeah, there you go.
What does that sound like? That sound like a girl wearer.
What do you think, Patriot? What would you say?
Yeah.
I don't know how to phrase it, but if you could work that in somehow, it might be nice.
Oh, then.
Thank you. That was so useful.
You should do something about that Molly thing. I hear the kids
are
eating.
That's what he does. He just gives suggestions. None of his robotics can compute how to make anything funny. He just comes up with premises.
Okay.
That's a good one, though. Molly, what's another drug?
I had one for Coke, but I cut it out because it was a minute. But
what is it?
Just like, you know, I start off saying, like, oh, Coke, that sounds like, you know, somebody said, hey, let's go in the bathroom and do Coke. Like, oh, sure, that sounds like a light, refreshing beverage, you know? Like, why don't we go in the bathroom and do some Coke with you? I don't know. But, like, I just, maybe that's weak, but.
Keep that one out.
Okay.
Yeah.
But I like your route on that. You know, keep going with, I see what you're doing there, and I agree with Tony at the beginning that you have so much setup that is unnecessary because I'm so worried, I'm thinking about bath salts, and then you don't have to listing off the drugs. And the funniest part was the, you know, the crystal meth girl, get into that. And I feel like that's what you want to do anyway.
Yeah. I mean, it came from a true story, obviously. Like, my roommate really was tweaking on a few drugs
right.
And then I thought, like.
But it's useless information at this point.
Right.
Okay, so it just
doesn't have to do with the things that end up banging in the end. So it actually ends up taking away from it because I'm still waiting for the roommate and the three drugs. Like, there's this information. These little fun
and I'm still thinking of abortion for some reason.
Right, I know.
Roommates are involved.
Jesus. Okay. That was really,
like, oh my
yeah.
God. There's a miscarriage happening in this bit. I don't know.
Okay.
Fuck yeah.
Very good stage press. I really enjoy it. I've seen you before. You're getting a lot better.
Oh, thank you.
What would Oxycontin, what does Oxycontin make you think of?
Like Oxypads.
Yeah, that's what I think of too. Like face clean.
I think of that 3-6 Mafia song.
Oxycontin.
Lil White.
Oxycontin seems like Lil White.
Lil White, that's a rapper's name. Lil White with a Y.
Really?
Yeah.
I always listen to. All right. Big Blocks. Anyway, it's a rap joke. People rap. Remember, it was okay that I said that because it was rap was the key topic there. Anyway, moving on. Fuck yeah. That's interesting how you spell your name, Chelse. That's Chelsea?
Yeah, my mom took the A off because she thought it looked too white, so she...
What's wrong with that?
That's what she told me. That's why she just said it, like, the EA just looked white, so she took it off.
What?
Well, I would have left the EA on it myself. But,
When did she tell you this?
She told me this when I, like, because I, you know, when I started, like, school, I was like, Mom, why is my name spelled like the traditional Chelsea? She said, oh, girl, that looked too white. I'd take that A off.
That is so funny. That is such a, like a strong black woman thing, right? To come up with a different name or something like that. Like, other names are, what was the one, that video that came out the other day, the Sharkeesha?
Oh, yeah, the Sharkeesha. Yeah.
Where did you grow up?
I grew up in Northern Virginia, right outside D.C.
Wow.
Yeah.
Is that like a hoodie area?
No. My mom's from Detroit, though. Like, she grew up miles, so that's, you know.
Gotcha.
Watch out.
Yeah, that's where she. So that's where that comes from. But no, I'm from like suburbs outside of D.C. So.
Fuck yeah. Well, awesome. There you go, Chelsea.
Okay.
At C the funny six. C, the letter G. C, That's what?
It's at C the Funny G, my last name.
C the Funny G.
Sorry.
Okay.
There you go.
Your G's
friends.
Look like sexes. There you go. Drugs, the word.
There's something to that Oxycontin one. That seems like
I
was trying
so.
To figure
it
that out.
It seems like Oxycontin would be a cotton ball that you clean your face with, right?
Yeah.
Like that clear cell thing, whatever?
Right.
Yeah.
Maybe smoking it when you're done, when it's all dirty. Mm-hmm. I don't know.
There's maybe probably. Wiping your face after the load's on it.
Oh. Yeah, there you go. Look at you.
What?
I love how you confidently take a sip of water after that.
Need some more water, Earl? You can have mine.
Go. Yeah, yeah, man. It's good for the
You're a growing man.
You got that right.
No, not that way.
Patriot, you having fun over there? How do you feel? You feel those lights on you at all? You okay?
Yeah, I'm looking beautiful, aren't I?
Hell yeah. Put your hands together for Derek Gruber, everybody. Ooh la la, could it be possible? Oh. It's been so long. Oh, this is so exciting. It's been weeks, basically, but when somebody misses their spot, that means that they get permanently blacklisted from the show. It will not be a Merry Christmas for Derek.
No commitment.
Mm.
Yikes. That's a permanent ban from the show and a 3-month ban from the Comedy Store.
Whoa.
Bobby Lee made that last part up, but all right. Anyway, put your hands together for Frank Castillo.
Oh, yeah.
He's here. He knows better.
Must die.
Hey, guys. Good to see everyone. I was reading the newspaper today. It's a really sad story. And it made me realize that I have a lot of anxieties, especially when I was reading the story. There's a 6-year-old, his dad got assassinated at his birthday party. And it was really, really sad. And then I realized it was because they dressed up as clowns. I thought that was kind of funny. And I thought, what was that must be like when they're interviewing that kid? It's like, what happened? Well, it was terrible. It was in the middle of the balloon animal trick. All I wanted was a giraffe. Instead, he made me an orphan. All right.
Did you think that with laughs that was going to be a minute?
Yeah.
The laughs are going to last 10 seconds.
10 seconds left.
Felt like an hour.
Still have 10 seconds left.
At least two for me, sir.
You still have 10 seconds. Anything you want to say?
Oh, man. Nothing that I could save.
Can you tell that joke when I'm given like 10 minutes?
Yeah, all right.
I messed up on like the first line, and then I was like, fuck, and then I tried to say.
What were you going to say?
Originally, I was going to say, you just start off, and I was like, I have a lot of anxieties. Like, I freak out about, stuff. Mostly, I have a fear of clowns, and I thought that was, and then I read the story about the 6-year-old who, his dad got assassinated at his birthday party, and then I started laughing. And I was like, that was funny, and then.
Is that true?
Yeah.
Okay,
it was actually
so
totally
a 6-year-old's dad got assassinated
at his birthday
and
party.
The dad was a clown.
No. That's where I fucked up. The assassins were dressed up as clowns.
Gotcha.
That's why that was.
Oh, wow. Much better.
Did they get away?
I don't know.
In a little car?
With the big shoes? The giant shoes just running down the street as fast as they can.
Like, was there a calling card a balloon animal?
Right, exactly. Would they shoot him with a water gun? He drowned to death via a water gun.
They just threw beanbags at him.
There you go.
I think we just found Bin Laden with that bomb.
Wow, that's interesting.
I'm trying to.
I think you get right into it.
Yeah.
Just by saying, I'm scared of clowns, especially more than ever, because bump.
Damn.
There you go.
Instead of, I get anxieties a lot, and one of the things that gave me anxiety was this article. I read the other, see all that? It's just like, go, gotta go, gotta go, gotta go, gotta go. When you get just bang, 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 and then people are like really waiting.
That's straight too.
And then you could add all any of those little things that we just said, But there's also, it's like so much.
Yeah.
There's so much to be made fun of about a clown assassin.
It has to be very clear, too. Because it was still confusing when you corrected yourself.
Yeah.
You're afraid of clowns. You read a story about clowns killing a kid's father at a party.
Yeah.
Okay.
The police sketch looks like Ronald McDonald.
So what you would feel is like that justifies me still being scared of clowns.
Exactly. Well, yeah. Oh, except this kid's fears is like, or that's the worst way to develop a fear of clowns. Like, I was scared of, like, a killer of clowns from Mars. Like, that was the movie that freaked me out of clowns. But that would be the worst.
That was the first thing that scared you?
Of clowns?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
No. I feel like it always starts in the dentist's office.
Really?
Did your dentist have pictures of clowns on the walls?
What the fuck?
No.
What kind of dentist did you go to?
I went to a creepy dentist.
you and the dolls in the house and your fucking clown dentist?
Yes. I swear to God, I'm not even fucking with you. I spent most of my childhood scared. Jeez. I'm not even kidding.
Clowns?
During the day, I was afraid of robbers, and at nighttime, I was afraid of fucking dolls and shit.
Wow.
But I wasn't really that afraid of clowns, but I remember the thing in the dentist's office, which was there to cheer the kids up, and it was fucking miserable. Anything that's smiling at you is scary, whether it's a clown or a doll or...
I think the movie It is the thing that really made me scared. Once I saw that, I was like, oh, I don't look at clowns the same anymore.
Right.
Fucking Stephen King, man. Yep.
So I see what you're trying to do is you're trying to compare your fear, how you got your fear for clowns, compared to how this kid got his fear of clowns.
Yes. Right.
And maybe the fact, you know, you could even say that the thing that started it with you is the killer clowns from outer space. And now you could say just like, I only thought killer clowns existed in outer space without saying that that's one of your favorite shows. That could just be your way of getting that joke in by saying, you know, or at the end or at the beginning. That could come in at any point because that's true to you. You're the one that said killer clowns from outer space, which was a terribly shitty movie. Remember that? Anyway,
it is a funny story though. I see what you're saying. If I'm reading that news article, like the party people, like you paid for entertainment, and they end up killing.
Oh my god!
the title for the newspaper was actually what caught me, and it was six clown assassins, and that's what it was. That was the title. It was like six clown assassins, and then I was like, I have to read this, and then I read it, and it was ridiculously.
Hmm. Where did it happen?
It was actually in Mexico.
Oh, that's not a surprise. Yeah, so when you say actually in Mexico, just know that I'm 90% at Mexico.
Yeah, it would be like, actually, it was in Canada would make sense or something.
That would have been shocking.
Happened in Iceland.
It was actually in the North Pole.
Mexican clowns. So Jesus, how many Mexican clowns can you fit in a tiny car, right?
Exactly.
There you go.
Yeah, that's
there
really
you
it.
Go right there.
Sweet.
Mexican killer clown. I thought they only exist in outer space. Turns out they exist in Mexico. Bobbity bobbity bob. Those other eight things that we said that were really funny. There you go, Frank Castillo, everybody. See, that's a good one. Why couldn't
Great
we have
job,
Frank go first?
I know.
I'm still mourning this dead baby.
Me too.
God bless that baby.
Yeah, I was. If you imagine that girl
that was,
like
that
going
was like
up,
the immaculate abortion.
Can you imagine that girl that's like sitting on the toilet and having a miscarriage.
Immaculate abortion? Awesome.
Dude,
let's not
naked.
Go back. Let's not go back. Frank Castillo, that was great. That's a fucking great news article you found. Killer clowns in Mexico. That's Frank C. Comedy on Twitter, at Frank C. Comedy, if you want to add more to let Frank know what's up. Here's an interesting one. Nick Scott Geyer. That's a new name. Oh, wow. Here he is.
Great music to bring up. Pick the worst song ever.
Put your hands together for Nick, everybody.
That's some good music. I like that. You know, it's so funny. I was thinking, I'm like, God damn, I hope I don't get picked. And right when you think that, you get picked. Well, let's see what I want to talk about today. Well, I just moved. Anyone here live in the Valley? Yeah. We all do, right? We all do. We all live in the Valley. Well, I just moved to the Valley, and I'm a gypsy. I don't really like... renting at apartments with people, with friends. I like to live in people's houses in a room, so I don't need to buy a fridge or I don't need to buy a bed. It's already there. It's already there for me. Well, I just moved into a new house in Sherman Oaks with this guy. He's a Jewish OCD guy. And apparently he's like, yeah, we have this other roommate there. He's from Turkey. His name is Burke. And I'm like, okay, all right. So I'm expecting to see this guy. He gets up at like about 5 a.m. and I try to get a look at him from outside, and I look and I see like a girl with long hair and leggings, and I'm thinking, okay, I'm not really sure if that's Burke, or maybe it's just his girlfriend. So then the next day I see him or her get up again, and someone's
That's a long story, man.
It is a long story.
That's a lot of setup.
That was actually a minute and five.
What's about to happen?
I still don't know if it's a guy or a girl.
Hey-o.
Shit.
I've been there.
You don't know if who's a guy or a girl.
My roommate. I don't know if it's like... I
oh,
don't know
really?
If I should say, are you Burke? Or just say, hi, my name is Nick.
Okay. How long have you lived there?
I've lived there about 2 weeks now.
And you just moved from where?
Hollywood Hills.
Hollywood Hills.
Okay. He's a gypsy.
How long have you been in L.A.?
5 years.
Wow. And now you're in the Valley?
Yeah.
Can't you check... Wait, so you can't tell the sex of your roommate. I mean, can you go into the, like, see if there's any tampons laying around? See, has it farted in front of you?
You can't see its dick? Like,
after it takes a shit, go in there and smell it. You could tell the difference.
Check for an Adam's apple. You gotta check for the Adam's apple.
Wow, I've never heard of that one before.
Like, there's two separate things. There's, like, a Venus, like, razor by the shower, but then there's, like, cologne right by the sink. So I'm not sure.
Maybe he's a fag.
Oh, my God. Geez. Earl.
Earl, why?
Jesus, transgender.
Jeez.
You really went for it, but I got to give you credit on that.
Venus razor and what's the other thing?
He had cologne.
Yeah, gay guys do those things. I'm in West Hollywood. I know what
Like, what kind of cologne are we talking about? Are we talking about, like, Calvin Klein? Are we talking about, like,
It's Calvin Klein.
Oh, boy.
It's a boy. Because no girl's going to wear Calvin Klein.
I rest my case.
Because that's just a cheap razor. Dude's a cheap ass. A Venus razor? Yeah.
That's what they use to shave their balls so it looks bigger.
Yeah.
You know a lot, Earl.
What do you think it really is?
I honestly thought it was just his girlfriend, but then the amount of times I've seen, like, the same leggings and long hair, like, I'm not sure, and I can never see him. I'm never there at the same time.
How were you in the Hollywood Hills before this? How'd you get that place?
I was living with a friend, and he, like, had a room, and he said, you don't need to give me money, just, like, a little bit.
Right.
And then I bet. Ding, ding, ding. And maybe I wasn't so wrong after all.
Oh, my God. How does that work out? I mean, does he just tell you when, and you just say you when?
Exactly. It's pretty
what?
Much
you like his sex
joking.
Way?
I'm completely joking.
All right, now we're crossing
That'd be a better
line.
Profession than what I'm already doing.
What's that?
What are you doing?
No, I work at a technology company.
That's cool. So you make money.
I make a little bit of money. It just sucks the life out of you.
What kind of technology?
Like the phone you have right now?
An iPhone? You work at Apple?
So you work
Are
at
you
the
afraid
Verizon
to say
store.
You work at Apple? Why'd you stop talking and started
no,
shaking
no,
your head?
No, like a phone like that. Like kind of a phone just like the iPhone. I work at a
Samsung.
Store. Possibly.
Can Could you not
Samsung?
Say the company you work for? Is that
I
a
can't
thing?
Say the company. That's,
it's
that's
Samsung.
A thing.
Wow.
So anyway, where do you work at Samsung?
I work at a technology company in the Beverly Center.
Oh, okay. Oh.
I live right by the Beverly
So
Center.
You work at True Religion?
I do.
Interesting. How long have you been doing stand-up?
A year now.
Mm-hmm.
So for his joke, he just needs to cut off the first 50 seconds.
Yeah. And even if you do find out if it's a girl or a man, well, how does that make you feel?
Right, yeah, you got
to
have
a big difference. Be something else. Yeah, I mean, like, we're getting there, and they're like, okay, what is it then? And you're like, I don't know. Like, well, fuck, why did I listen?
It's right. just like one of the random questions I have, like, about the whole living situation. So just even have one thing answered is like, okay, well, at least, like, now I know. Like,
oh, okay.
So there's no air of mystery where I want to be like, hey, girl, or hey, like, Burke. Like, I don't want to say, hey, Burke, where are you going?
That's really the thing's name? Burke?
Yeah, Burke.
Burke.
That is a tough call.
That could be him or one. I mean, that's right
that's
on the line.
That's why I'm confused. And I don't want to be rude. I don't want to be...
Burke. Because it's like, that sounds like a guy's name, but I also think the only person that I've heard of is like Delta Burke.
It's almost
and
like
even
you
though
should,
it's their last
you should
name.
Start right there and then...
It's designing the women.
There's like
Burke
all
Williams.
Your investigation, everything, you know.
The whole
like,
investigation?
The, all of it, yeah. I don't want to hear about the backstory, and no one cares
it's
about
It's a lot of backstory.
Just get to it quicker, you know.
Remember they had that character on Saturday Night Live called Pat? You didn't know if it was a girl or a guy?
Yeah.
I knew.
You could just...
Oh, there you go.
You could just...
There you go, Patriot. Good job.
You could just Google Burke's name, and it'll come up and tell you if it's a male and a female.
I did
not
that.
Necessarily.
I tried it on Facebook, and...
You work at a technology company. Figure it out.
You're right. I probably should have a little more.
Just Google it, man.
Bing it, bro.
Real or fake eyebrows?
Are you at? Who are you talking to? The Patriot? Yeah, those are fake.
But the guy, the girl. No, this guy. The guy that's on stage right now.
Does
it have real or fake eyebrows?
Oh, does it? Oh, Burke.
Yeah.
Okay. I didn't really get a good look at it. Like, I was half asleep, and I looked outside.
So it's like Bigfoot. You're like, oh, the...
It was like in the morning, and I didn't. I just caught a glimpse.
It's like a mythical creature.
Did you
and
look?
Then
at
I left my door open one time just for him or her to specifically walk by, and I saw, and I just saw the same like leggings and long hair walk by it. So I'm like,
could have been Bon Jovi. Long hair.
Yeah. Could have been Bon Jovi. I mean,
it could have been. True. I could be rooming with Bon Jovi.
Maybe this is Burke's double life. Is he's actually Bon Jovi, and he just needed a roommate in the valley.
Could have been Patriots, one of his old band members. Yeah.
I'm thinking just it's transgender, probably.
Yeah, hey, probably.
You know, Jared Leto is playing...
Sounds like that'd be a cheap roommate to have.
Jared Leto is playing a transgender character in this new film, Dallas Buyers Club. Could be Oscar-worthy.
That's that AIDS movie.
Yeah.
If you watch it backwards, it ends better.
Oh, my God. All right, Nick, good luck, man. I don't know, yeah. That's an interesting one. Figure out what it is and have
Merry
More
Christmas.
Jokes, less setup. Merry Christmas. Nick Scott Geyer. We didn't even get to a punchline with that. That was interesting. You guys remember when you first started out? Were there any jokes that you did back then that you were embarrassed about?
Most of them.
Can't believe you did?
Mm. All of them.
Yeah.
You remember one specifically that you'd be embarrassed?
I remember
to
the
say
second
right now?
Time I went up on stage, we had 5 minutes, and I timed out 5 minutes in my bedroom thinking, I got it. Mm-hmm. And then when I first went up there, some guy goes, "You look stupid." I was like, "I'm not prepared for this."
You look stupid.
Yeah. Ruined my whole 5 minutes. I timed it for 5 minutes, and that threw me off.
Has that happened ever since then?
Oh, I mean, I get heckled all the time. So
with that, you look stupid.
Yeah,
I've never heard that before. And
I mean, at the time, I
don't think you
look
stupid. Why? What did you do?
I think I don't know. I said something like him. I'm like, I think I want to talk about sex. And then you tell this whole long story. And you're not even really talking about sex.
Right.
And some guy was like, you look stupid. I'm like, yeah, I do.
Yeah.
You won.
That's funny. Patriot, did you ever do anything like in between songs to try to be funny or entertaining? Or was it just those songs?
I usually was getting my next outfit on. Because, like, if I was doing mailman, I had to get my mailman shirt.
Can you imagine? It's already imagine you're at a concert with that, with the kind of music you heard earlier. And in between those shitty songs, you have to wait for him to go through a costume change.
Wardrobe change!
So he comes back out in a different outfit, still just bombing his ass off.
Keep in mind, it took a while to hand out all those bananas. Before the Share My Banana song, I'd be throwing bananas out, like it was a crowd like this. I'd throw all the bananas out, everybody get situated, start going like this, and then the song starts.
You know, one thing that was in the that made it to the Kill Tony movie trailer was the fact that you stuck your, what you call a banana, into a vacuum cleaner three times. And you finished inside the vacuum cleaner.
That was when I was younger. We all make mistakes when we're younger.
What do you think's the worst fire hazard? You doing that then, or you being covered in those Christmas lights right now?
Probably both.
Did anything crazy ever happen?
What are you talking about?
When you had an orgasm inside of a vacuum cleaner.
Well, it sucks it dry, cleans it off. You're ready to go on your way after that.
Just use a wet vac, right?
Only costs 50 cents for an orgasm.
It'd be so funny to see that weird porno, like you in that outfit fucking a vacuum cleaner. Maybe it's just me. All right. fuck yeah. Nick Scott Geyer went from the Hollywood Hills to the Valley. What a downgrade, huh?
He said he's a gypsy.
I guess.
A fancy way of saying couch surfer, for sure.
Yeah, definitely. Not even that good. Gypsies are an interesting people. You know about them? What do you know about gypsies?
They recycle all my shit for me.
Really?
Yeah. They're in my trash out every night.
Clark Mick. Wait, what?
They have good scarves.
There you go. For those of you interested in the scarving industry, they do have good scarves. Clark McMakin, everybody. Here he is.
Yeah, give it up for Clark.
What's up, guys? What's up, Internet? All right, wow.
Drinking.
My friend used the term worst case scenario the other day. I've always found that term a little underwhelming. Hey man, ask her out. Worst case scenario, she says no. So I'm a little more creative than that. Hey, man, ask her out. Worst case scenario, you date for a little while. She gets pregnant. You get married for the sake of the baby. She turns abusive, goes to hit you one day, falls down, breaks her head. You get blamed. Spend the rest of your life in jail. And when you're being violated in the shower, your only thought is, my child's never going to love me. Worst case scenario. I saw a 70-year-old woman with a rape whistle, and my first thought was, wow, that's optimistic. Followed very closely by my second thought, which was, oh my God, Clark, you're an ass. That is literally the opposite of optimism. You can't get further away than that. Thank you.
Clark McMakin. That's an interesting last name. Is that your real last name?
That's my real last name.
McMakin? Mm-hmm. That's so cool. Fuck yeah. So I'd lose the end part of the rape whistle thing.
All
right. You got it on the first part, right? I didn't get that last thing. Did you? Did I miss something? The opposite of optimism?
Yeah, I mean, I would cut that last part out. And you got
it's smart, but I don't think it's funny. Easy. Yeah. The 70-year-old woman with a rape whistle.
You'll That's fit in well. Here at this place with that joke.
Yeah.
I forgot how it was like to like hit so many dark jokes, you know?
That's so funny.
And God agrees.
There you go.
He agrees. God's like, can we talk about abortion and rape? And
did someone's prayer? Did someone's prayer?
Oh, my God.
That was a shout-out from the miscarriage ghost of Sarah Penny.
Yeah, that's for all the AIDS jokes we've done up here tonight.
Yeah. So maybe there's something about like a 70-year-old lady with a rape whistle, you know, does she have lung capacity to blow it? Maybe she gets it confused with a life alert. Like, is that a rape
alert? Yeah, I was thinking that. That's exactly what I was thinking.
Maybe she's like just fiddling for which necklace. Like, fuck, what disaster is happening? You know, like, I don't know. You know, and what was the first one? The first one's funny.
The first one was the worst case scenario.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that one's, yeah, that's good. Yeah, that's good. That's one of those jokes that gets an applause break in a real comedy room because it's dobbity, 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 and then it summons that at the end. Mm-hmm. Fuck yeah. So, 70-year-old with a rape whistle. What would you think if you saw a 70-year-old with a rape whistle?
I'd get hard.
Big Earl, everybody. Yeah.
Especially when you know it's already happened once.
Yeah, yeah. You can't catch AIDS twice.
Okie dokie. fuck yeah.
I don't really have any notes. I've seen you a long time ago. I remember you did potluck about 2 years ago.
Back when you hosted.
Yeah, yeah, Willie, you get to see everybody.
I know,
right?
It's been a while. And again, like Chelsea, you've come a long way. Very, very funny.
Thank you.
Yeah, so give it up for Clark, everyone.
Tony hosted for me once too, but he has no recollection of it. And that's the right response.
You're saying I brought you up while I was hosting?
Oh, sure.
And you had the same last name then?
Yeah.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Wow. I haven't changed. I haven't got married since then.
The reason why I remember
you did?
Him.
I did not get married and changed my name since then.
Well, even if you got married, you know you'd keep your last name, right?
That's the plan.
Okay, just making sure.
That not always happens, by the way. I know two guys that took the woman's
name. Well, those guys are giant pussies.
Yeah, they are.
That's like the most I've heard people talk about that before, and that's so gross to me. Like, how much do you have to hate your father to take your? How much do you have to hate where you came from to be like, you know what? I'm just gonna take your last name. Nothing on that. I
mean, some people would do that.
You would? Would you?
I would think about it.
You wouldn't think.
Oh, I would think about it. It depends on the girl.
Right.
There you
You're
go.
So full of shit.
I swear to God. I mean, this girl's like, you know, Oprah. Yeah, sure, I'll take her name.
Willie Winfrey?
Yeah.
Get the fuck out of here.
I absolutely would.
You would not do that.
Absolutely, in a heartbeat.
Willie Winfrey, and your career is over.
Yeah. Man, I'll be
You'd be standing right next to the Patriot over there.
Wait, who's that celebrity?
In extras,
celebrity.
Not it. Yeah. Patriot gets so disappointed. I'm talking about it as a background extra, not as the
Isn't there a celebrity that recently did it, that took the woman's name? Was it somebody pretty famous, I think, like John Stanton. No. Who?
Brad.
Oh, yeah.
Brad Pitt.
Jay-Z.
What are we just naming random?
Yeah, I think so.
Willie Tyler.
It is it?
Fuck yeah, there he goes. Clark McMakin. He's on Twitter at Clark McMakin, C-L-A-R-K-E.
Good job, Clark.
M-C-M-A-K-I-N. I don't really think that there's no way
that's his real name.
He's my favorite so far. I liked him a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's fun.
This is fun. I'm still over that, you know, abortion thing at the beginning, but
yeah, I know. Normally it's like this the whole time, but we had a dead baby on our hands tonight. This was a special episode of Kill Baby. Put your hands together for Mike Donovan, everybody. Here he comes. Deep in the gullet.
Oh, how's everybody, man? How's everybody's credit? Mine is shit. I'm leaving my social security number everywhere I go now. Just hoping someone steals my identity. And can't get any worse. It's been a rough week. My miscarried baby committed suicide. And playing B pill. Can't leave those things around. It's power. So, recently celebrated a birthday. Wow, thank you for that. Appreciate it. Oh, yeah. 42. For a gift, I gave myself diabetes. I didn't mean to. But that's what happens when you have unprotected sex with a 400-pound white woman. You get diabetes. Okay, apparently this is Jenny Craig meeting here. I'm sorry. It's not a white woman. Oh, wow. That killed. I thought...
It sure did.
This is wow. Can I get the meow sound? I'm dying. Yes, thank you. Thank you. Okay, apparently everyone has diabetes. I apologize.
Oh, no.
Okie dokie. There he goes. Mike Donovan. fuck yeah. All right. Where are you from?
Connecticut.
Oh. How long have you been here?
2 years.
Really? Yeah. Doing stand-up?
No, acting.
What happened to your voice? Oh, you're talking to Mike.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. 2 years. Acting, but no, I'm doing some writing. Because just to stay busy.
Wait a minute, you're writing?
I'm writing.
Oh, that's a zinger.
No. That's a real question.
Yeah, no, I ran for a show out in New York called Cheap Seats, Scholar Brother thing.
Yeah.
Oh,
wow.
I like how you said that. Like, so you guy like really likes Cheap Seats as a Scholar Brother. It's no big deal.
I thought you were going to say you wrote on Free Agents.
I'm going to get rid of that diabetes thing. Cause I
really didn't remember. Yeah. You caught it, too, as you said.
I don't know what it was. I think it was a silence that really made it really...
Yeah.
No, it's just not that good, you know?
You know what's funny, man?
No.
Do you have diabetes?
Yeah.
Do you really?
Yeah.
You really do?
I really do.
Did you catch it or did you have it? Which kind do you have?
Well, my parents gave it to me.
I bet.
Fuck yeah.
Fat gene.
There you go.
See, the truthful
See,
stuff.
There you go.
I love your energy. When he first came up here, I was laughing
the
way he ran
the
down.
Yeah, energy, right? But then I lost it with the,
I mean, even the joke that you wrote made me giggle that you wrote about the abortion or the...
Well,
calling out the awkwardness. Yeah, I was waiting for somebody to do that.
Thank you, for sure. Well, that's one good thing I did. That's nice.
That's true. There you go. If we're pointing out one good thing you did, that would be correct.
It's very Brian Holtzman.
Very much
Brian Holtzman. Mm-hmm. Extremely confident for a guy in sweatpants. I like that.
You know,
most guys from Connecticut
aren't
like that.
Casual look.
We know it's a casual look. It's
definitely. I didn't wear shorts. It's even worse. I didn't wear and a tank top.
Oh no, we don't want.
What do you wear during the summer? That mesh shorts, tank top,
cut off jeans.
I feel like you're like always watering your front lawn.
No, man.
Or getting the newspaper.
You look like that kind of guy. Or getting the newspaper just over and over.
He's like, I'm going for a jog. And he puts that on and gets some coffee. That's it.
Going for a jog.
He just says that.
You definitely seem very, like, wife beater wearing-esque. You seem like you wear wife beater. I was going to guess Jersey when you said, but I was surprised that you said Connecticut. But New York.
Yeah,
what do you have
I lived
like?
In New York. Yeah, so right. 6 years, New Jersey.
Gotcha.
A little bit.
Yeah.
So it's there. Oh, Italian thing. And East Coast and. Fucking up fat diabetes jokes. That's what I do.
Yeah. Well, you know that one about the miscarried baby that commits suicide? How'd you come up with that one?
Oh my God, Patriot. Are you serious?
And I heard it, and then I thought, wait. No one's really touched on that.
Right.
And I'm like, someone needs to touch on it. So
true.
I should have left after that. Just walk up. No, that's
well, it's just, you know, this is one of those examples where some jokes that are unbelievable can hit, but some jokes, if it seems like it's dabbling in both,
yeah,
and it's like, does he have or what? And it sort of gets lost in translation. So
it's like you came up with that energy and you did that riff on The Room, and then you realize, right. Oh shit, I gotta tell material.
Yeah,
and it doesn't hold up to this.
And that's true, you know.
And I had so much other good material, I just forgot it after the silence, so it kind of threw me. Yeah. Like, I was so
how long have you been doing stand-up?
Just like maybe a year.
Oh,
maybe a year. Like, what do you mean?
Like, it's like sporadic. It was like a little bit in New York, then I picked it back up again here a few months ago.
Are you having fun doing it?
Not right now. I want to kill myself. I want to take a plan B.
Well, other times
you're kill myself.
I like your personality though.
Me too.
Thank you, man.
Yeah, it's very likable.
Can I just stand up here and just like hang out and then like
nah.
No, hit the bricks.
Oh wow.
Fuck yeah. There he goes, everybody. Mike Donovan. Welcome. Glad to have you on.
Keep it up.
I would talk about that stuff, about that real shit, how you look like a guy that would wear a wife beater and mow your lawn and get your newspaper. There's something funny about that, about wearing sweatpants, mesh shorts.
Yeah, you're
really... That's who you really are, so...
He's refreshing, too. Like, I want to see more of that guy.
Yeah. Good personality, man.
Yeah. You didn't catch diabetes from having sex with that. It was confusing on multiple levels.
Yeah, you're not skinny enough to make that joke. You know what I mean?
Damn.
Like, you know, if you said like diabetes, right. Like I don't understand. Like,
right?
I didn't get it. You know?
Mm-hmm. It's
like
true.
The fat woman. You know?
It's confusing for a few different reasons. You're welcome. Just want to make sure you never try that one again.
Yeah, please don't.
Sometimes we give people
like
things
so much.
That
I
adds
like you
on,
so much.
And then sometimes it's just more important to just. Sometimes the best offense is a great defense.
Mm-hmm.
There you go. So this is the part where we have our two regulars that come on every week with a new 60 Seconds, and it's always fun to watch them grow. You've both seen them, so it's exciting for you to see them again, since this is the return of Willie and Earl. In no particular order this week, let's go with first, hey, you know her from the Kill Tony podcast and also the Kill Tony podcast. Put your hands together for Sarah Wineshank, everybody. Here she is.
I've been going through the motions a lot of procrastination. Nothing's getting done. I want to work out, and instead of actually working out, I'll just put it on my to-do list. I'll get dressed up to go to the gym, but I won't go to the gym. Just going through the motions, guys. I'll wash a dish, a pan. I won't fully wash it, right? I just let that shit soak. You ever do that? You ever just let that shit soak? So you feel like you're doing something with your life, but you're not. You're just letting old crusted eggs sit at the bottom of a pan. My roommate came in and said, "What the fuck is this? Are you gonna do that?" And I said, "I'm just letting it soak." Sometimes that's what you gotta do, guys. All right.
I love it, as always. There's something about your cadence. You're so weird and goofy, and you know it took weeks for me to notice that that's exactly who you are. So now, and I know Red Band feels the same way, because I noticed that each week we both start, no matter what you're saying, laughing at about 20 or 30 seconds in, like contagiously. But that soak thing is really, you know, that's something that I've noticed even myself doing once in a while, where it's like, I remember my mom always telling me, you know, let it soak.
Yeah.
And it'll come off easier when you wash it. And it's like, you know, that's a procrastination trap if there's ever been one before. Then all of a sudden you have a little.
Every 3 days I'll just add more soap. It's like, I just did the dishes again.
It'll just kill whatever's in this petri bowl that I've let marinate in my kitchen.
Man, have you ever had the dishes so bad where it's just like gelatin, black gelatin? Like it just turns into like jello, like black mold jello?
No, that's just you.
I don't think I have.
Wow. Yeah, I used to be that way when I was younger. I let it soak. But when I got older, I realized it's just best. Clean it right after you get done. Just take care of it and it's done. You don't have to worry about it. Don't let it. You know, sometimes you got those scrambled eggs that are hard to clean off, but just do it right then.
Patriot, how old are you?
I'm 47. I just had a birthday on December 4th.
Put your hands together.
Happy birthday, man.
I didn't tell anybody. I'm kind of humble that way.
Oh, my God.
Well, you just told us.
<That's>... Well, I wanted you to know that I just turned 47, so it wouldn't sound so bad.
Oh, happy birthday. Happy birthday, Patriot. 47 is a good year.
I look young for my age, though.
Hell yeah, you do. A Patriot suit.
Yeah. Well, Well, you get other 47-year-olds across the country. How many of them could wear this costume?
No, you're damn right. And I see you in the background of everything, man.
Yeah.
It's awesome.
You know what really made me happy? You got to talk with Joey about me, and Lee Syed actually saw some of my screenshots. I was amazed.
Yep.
You're really doing good things for me, Tony. You keep telling all these comedians about me. I love you for that, guy.
What are you, Dean Delray?
No, thank you so much.
Tony, guys.
We're having a Christmas moment here together.
I love it. No, it's true. I'm so glad that we joined forces 30 weeks ago, and it's exciting to be where. I know it's weird because I threw Christmas lights on you earlier and taped an elf hat to your helmet, but I really love you too, Patriot.
Fucking
room. I bet it is.
Yeah, we're going to go get a room. That's
get
what we're going to do.
Get a room.
We're going to go get a hotel.
Go get have an abortion together.
Yeah. I got a man crush on you, Tony.
All See? Right. I was right.
Anyway, that's fun. I'd stretch out the soaking thing, right? You ever soak dishes, Earl? You live by yourself in a big fancy apartment. What's that like? You ever soak dishes?
Exactly how I wash dishes, so I really liked it.
Okay. I wanted to just start out with soaking, you know?
I think you should do that.
But it's like, I didn't feel like it was developed enough. I kept thinking about soaking like all last week, and I only had a little bit about soaking, so then I was like, fuck, it's not full, and I want to do it for a minute.
Maybe you could do different levels of soaking, you know? Like, I noticed that one thing that I've done before is, like, you know, I come home late, bobbity-bob, you know, I eat something, say, out of a bowl, I'll fill it up with water, right, and leave it in the sink.
Yeah,
and then get back to it the next day or whatever it is, you know what I mean? Or if it happens in the morning, vice versa, but anyway. But sometimes what I'll do after that is, and there's also that soap thing that he does that's crazy, but also is I'll fill up the whole sink with water
after that.
So it's almost like a refresh, and then you're like, well, now the edges are getting soaked for the first time, not just the inside. So you can rationalize. If you take people through that trip of you rationalizing and truly procrastinating, because I think a lot of people can relate to that, and I think that's where the root of it being so funny lies, is that I think that sounds like the kind of joke that you'd have a lot of people coming up to you after the show. I do the same thing when I soak dishes. And that's sort of what you want, is jokes that people will remember you by and be able to relate, especially, you know, really connect with. Yeah. So there you go. Another great new 60 seconds. Sarah Weinshank. She's Princess Shank on Twitter. S-H-E-N-K.
She is so funny. I love her.
Yeah, it's super cool. So happy to have her be part of the show, as well as our other regular. She dropped out of college and kills every 60 we watch her grow at 60 seconds at a time every week. No pressure. The hilarious Kimberly Congdon, everybody. Here she is.
Hey, guys. I want to talk about gay people right now, and I don't want to just talk about any old gay people. I want to talk about flamboyant gay guys, because there's a difference, right? There's, like, the manly gay that, like, suck dick on tractors with big muscles and shit, and then there's this guy that I started working with who I had this conversation in an elevator with. He goes, oh, my God, Kim, did you see Matthew on the second floor? He is so fucking hot. And he stayed like that. And I was like, should I slow clap, you know? And, like, I just don't get it. Like, is there, like, a thing that when you're coming out of the closet, you have to pick a size of gay you are? Like, there's, like, gay, medium gay, and super fucking gay! I don't know. It's just awful. Like, holding a conversation with them is difficult, you know? If someone was like, Kim, you have 1 minute to live, I'd probably spend it talking to him because it feels like forever.
Okie dokie. Kimberly Congdon. Fuck yeah. So, all right. Let's get to it.
I like the pose thing. People should have hit that pose a little bit longer.
Yeah.
That was funny.
That was the moment where I felt like the balloon was filled with the most air, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
For a pop to happen. The slow clap isn't it.
No.
That's not where to go.
I thought the sucking dick line was too early. Cause
really? I thought we were into it.
Well, no, I just think it was so shocking right out of the shoot. Yeah. You might lose people on, wow, that's, you know.
Yeah, maybe.
Okay.
Maybe. That's an interesting one.
Been working a lot, so I've been talking about my coworkers a lot.
And you're saying, I'm getting on from the joke, so you'd rather be with really flamboyant gay guys?
No. I'm okay with gay people, but there's just like a whole another level that some gay, like they're like more than women.
Like Jeff Scott, you know, the piano player. Like, hey.
More than women?
Just, yeah, it's like you're like, more than a woman, like more.
Like Liberace.
Was he gay? I had no idea.
I like the levels. I like that joke, the level of gay, because it is, you know.
Yeah, when you're coming out of the closet, that's definitely a part to keep. You know, okay. Do you have to choose? Do you have to commit to that? Like,
the structure too. Like, I kind of agree with Earl. You saying like saying that at the beginning, like the structuring of like the route that we're going on this joke, like the coming out of the closet part probably should be earlier on, so we can know where you're going with this. Like, you know, how do they choose a side when they come out? And then you say which one you prefer, and then I do the pose, and then you think of a better, you know, end besides the slow clap. But I can't think of one now, but.
Right. Like, what did you do? This is usually what answers
it.
Yeah.
I just stare at him for a while, and I was like, do you have to, take a class when you come out to be that annoying?
You said that to him?
I said that to him.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Jesus.
You're just like a mean girl. Yeah.
You homophobe.
We're on that level now, him and I.
So what did he say to that? Right.
He laughed. And he,
right,
he,
because
he
you're a girl, and that's what those guys do, right?
Yeah, he laughed, and then he faked.
Oh, he
and
does
I was
that.
Like, fuck. Oh my God!
Jamie have
does
hair?
That.
Our, have
he
hair?
No, he does. He has really short hair, and he.
No, yeah, our gay buddy Jamie does that.
It's
Jamie
awful.
Salida. You know, Jamie does this thing where he's like, ooh.
Is Jamie gay?
But he's always putting this piece
so
of hair
that
doesn't
that
even exist.
Yeah.
Like, oh.
Right. Well, there's something that you might as well take with it because that's a real thing about him. And we can't do a joke about it because it's our buddy that we do. But there's something about, like, what is this imaginary piece of
gay hair? But I love it coming from
hair.
A woman's perspective talking about gay people. Like, because as a man, we're like, all right, this guy's really, really gay. But I can't talk about it without seeming homophobic. But you're a girl, it's like, hey, I can talk about it. It's just comforting. Yeah. So I don't mind you explaining it.
Yeah.
Right.
Well. My friend, I had a friend that came out. And before when he was still hiding it, he was normal. But then, like, 2 years later, I saw him after coming out of the closet, and he was the most flamboyant, like, person in the world. Like, just
he's
crazy.
Like,
turned up to, like, 30 on the gay meter.
Yeah, he picked extra gay.
Yeah.
Semen will do that to you.
Yeah. What if it's just, like, the best B12 ever, just that cum under your tongue?
All right.
Well, I mean, that's a little much, but, I mean.
Maybe a good song, huh?
Cum under your tongue.
Sounds like something.
Maybe Patriot could write that.
Come on your tongue.
Come on your tongue.
1+1 is come on your tongue.
It fills your belly.
Yeah,
every
song
fucking
like
song.
In the early 80s, remember, Lick It
Lick
Up.
Lick It Up, written by Vinnie
Lick
Vincent.
Were they talking about cum?
Yeah. They also had a song.
That was when they took their makeup off. You know, they first showed us what they looked like.
Yeah, they should have kept it on.
Yeah.
Fuck yeah, I'd lose the act out part. I'd keep that other stuff. I'd keep it real. I'd even talk about how you called him an idiot about how you might be wondering if he got mad. But no, he didn't get mad because he's a flamboyant gay guy and those guys agree with everything that a woman says. You know what I mean? They laugh at everything. It seems like that, like, oh, you're so silly. You know what I mean? Like, whatever. So just keep telling it like it is and keep noticing those fun stories and keep trying to turn them into something always because you have 60 seconds to fill every week. Because she's Kimberly Congdon, everybody, and this is what she does.
Thank you, guys.
She's on Twitter at Kimberly Congdon. Do check out that Kill Tony trailer. Willie, Earl, what do you guys got coming up? You're on Twitter at The Will Hunter Show, right?
Yeah. I got nothing really planned. I'm going to do New Year's Eve here at the Comedy Store for the first time.
Yeah. That's a lot of fun. Yeah, I'll be on that show with you.
It's going to be very fun. That's Willie Hunter Show. We'll be back. Next year.
Yeah, check out his show. Earl's his co-host. They've had Sarah Silverman, Bill Burr, a lot of great shows. Gerard Carmichael.
Chelsea Peretti. Ricky Ingram, Brody.
Oh, jeez. All,
Sam
all,
Tripoli. Yeah,
all of some of our favorites here.
Esther
and,
Pavitsky.
Fun.
Well,
there you go.
she's been on the
show.
She
was on the first show.
She was.
What a way to start off a show.
Earl, what do you got coming up?
A few Rob Schneider gigs coming up, and just found out my pilot's coming out on Netflix, so.
Fuck yeah, buddy. You know?
Yes.
Put your hands together for that. That's Earl Skakel.
Yeah.
Check him out in Benchwarmers. What's your website?
GhettoGaggers.com.
Follow him on Twitter at Earl Skakel, right?
Yeah, just EARL SKAKEL.
The Iron Patriot is on Twitter at Comic Patriot. He's with us every episode. Thanks for dressing like a Christmas elf tonight. Yeah. Oh, hey, everybody. It's the Roastmaster Twitter. I'll set her up. Wow. What a special treat. One of my good friends.
Great show tonight, you guys. Wasn't a great show?
Thank you. You must not have seen the other 29 episodes, yeah. But this was blatantly the worst show we've ever had. But
which makes it a great show.
Thank you.
I love it. You should turn this into a podcast. I just wanted to come by and give you a Christmas present.
Oh, thank you so much.
Tony Hinch, as a way of saying thank you for being a great buddy and also
thank you.
Congratulations on your show being awesome.
Oh, thanks. Can I open it
now? Yeah, open it up.
Okay,
it's great. A custom-made Hackett jacket.
By the way, I like your sweater.
Thank you very much.
Little baby.
Whoa, that's so cool. That's a Buddy Hackett
jacket.
How awesome is
Buddy
that?
Hackett jacket.
Oh, wow. That's cool.
Thank you so much,
Merry
Jeff.
Christmas,
Heck
buddy.
Yeah,
great
Merry
show
Christmas,
tonight, you guys.
Man. Thank
Everybody
you.
Was awesome.
Oh, Jeff Ross,
Jeff Ross.
Everybody.
Thank you, Jeff.
One of my best pals. How exciting.
Come on, guys. It's the Roastmaster.
Fuck yeah. Thank you so much. This is awesome. That's Buddy sweet. Hackett jacket.
That's hilarious.
And, I don't know if they're going to bring it up here, but you're also the Fantasy Football League champion.
Yeah, I just won the Comedy Store belt. You're going to be seeing me wear it because I'm going right down there to grab it because it just became official during this show. I won the Fantasy Football League. The name of my team is the Hinchcliffe Winners, and it eats the other people alive that I won this belt. It's hilarious because I'm the bad guy. You get it?
All right.
Follow Red Band at Red Band. Go to killtony.com. Well, that just leads you to my website. But we're going to Houston, Dallas, and Austin January 9th, 10th, and 11th.
Go to deathsquad.tv for your tickets.
Yes. You can go to iTunes and download every episode and have fun. And check out Thunder Pussy and other fun things going on Death Squad. Merry Christmas, everybody. See you in the new year. Who wouldn't go up on the housetop? Click, click, click.